Yeah, those who were shipped over to the Rocky Mountains were called, as our post receiving officer once saw, a big list where we were listed under the heading Black and Ardent Nazis. Aha! So we thought, and our comrades thought, this is one, that not. They had assembled all those who had written so-called letters for the sender. That means a letter which would never get through to our families, but where he opened his valve and was shedding abuse on the Allies, or what like that. Those ones. The escapers, autonomous-minded ones.
All the naughty ones.
Yeah, the naughty ones. We're all there.
Okay, so you were released a little bit later.
Yeah, because of this, I was released a bit of later. We were even in Britain. While we were there, we were against international law. We were politically classified. There was a man who spoke German. In my case, it was a Czech, and who asked questions, and I was answering, huh? And I got classified as a Nazi, Group C, A, B, C. A were very clean, B were shady, C were the big. And even some chaps had the classification, as I later heard, C plus. Yeah. We were first, since we were in British hands, we had been released in a British camp in Germany, and that was Munsterlager, north of Hanover. And there we came into a big hall, long tables, and there were British soldiers, and here were we, and we had our luggage to be controlled. But they were very uninterested. Big chalk cross on my sea sack, and not looked into. But I saw in a corner standing the rests and the trimmer, when you have destroyed furniture, stand all heaped up. And I said to one of the Britishers, "What is that?" "Ah," he said. Another day before, he said, the rest of the crew of the Panzerschiff Graf Spee, who were interned had been interned in Argentine, were coming through here. And they all were very well to do. They had a lot of things which they possessed. And we had Polish control soldiers on the other side, not us. And the Polish ones were starting to pull out things from these sailors, luggage, for themselves. And then one of the sailor superiors gave a pfeife through the fingers. And they jumped over the table onto the poles, and they were hitting them. And some of us stood in the rear, and we said to them, "Do what you want, but no debt." And so the rest of the furniture standing there. And then they went unrobbed or unstealed away, these rest of the crew. And since then, there was peace in the field, and so the Britishers didn't look into ours. And then we came on a train, on a goods train, partly open wagons, partly with sliding doors. And the train was going very slowly. The rails were yet damaged, the bridges were damaged. So to the south, I was going to the south, to the American zone, where my engaged, was living there. And where we halted, the populace was streaming on our train, were beautifying it with twigs and with even flowers outside, and we thought at last that we were a victorious battalion coming home. So our populace was well in order then. And then we arrived in the American zone, and there at Dachau we were released again.